workers go to great pains to protect the safety of those they care for, sometimes at the expense of their own health and well-being. This is one reason why care workers in Nova Scotia experience the highest rate of time loss injuries in the province, and it's something we need to change. We know that when steps are taken to protect the safety of the care worker and the safety of the person being cared for, everyone wins. When fewer care workers are injured, they are at work and able to provide better care to those who need it. Care tasks that require people to be moved or repositioned are a leading cause of injuries to care workers. This video, one in a series focusing on safe handling and mobility techniques and activities, was created to demonstrate recommended safe handling and mobility-related work practices and techniques. Throughout the video, think about how the care worker interacts with the person receiving care and their coworkers, and how they use PACE, the Point of Care Mini Risk Assessment, to help ensure the safety of everyone involved. Before we watch the care providers help Vanessa get up and into the chair after a fall, we want to reassure you that her primary care provider has checked Vanessa's care plan and understands her safe handling and mobility plan. As the care provider enters Vanessa's room, she quickly notices Vanessa isn't in bed, but is on the floor in front of the toilet. Quickly moving to Vanessa's side, the care provider checks Vanessa's ability to communicate and her level of agitation, making sure there are no unexpected hazards, while also using the call bell to get assistance.
Not a great way to start the day.
No, it's not.
All right, we're just gonna wait a few minutes for the other nurse to come help us, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning, Tara. We've had a fall. Do you think you could get the nurse to come in, please?
Absolutely.
Good morning, Vanessa.
I hit a fall.
I see that. Did you hit your head?
No, I didn't.
I'm going to take this blanket away so I can give you a check over, okay?
Okay.
Do you have any pain?
No.
Everything okay?
Yes.
I'm just going to check for any lumps or bumps.
Okay.
Do you think you'd be able to get up if we gave you some help?
Yes, I think I can.
Is there anything else I can help you guys with?
No, I don't think so. I think we're good.
Thanks, Tara.
Jen, if you could get the chair, please.
Sure.
All right, Vanessa, I'll take that pillow out from under there. Do you think you could roll up on your hands and knees for me? We're just going to put this little belt around you so I can help you up, okay?
Okay.
Do you want to reach up here on the chair? Both hands? I'm going to get you to lift this leg up and put your foot flat on the floor. Okay? We're going to stand up together on three. You ready?
Yes.
One, two, three. Up. Nice and tall. There, how's that feel?
That feels good.
All right, do you want to turn around with me and we'll have a seat? There we go.
Thank you.
You doing all right?
I'm doing okay.
Okay, we'll get your walker.
Okay.
And then we'll take you over toward the bed and then I'll have a good look at you, okay?
Okay.
Push off from the chair.
Okay.
One, two, three, up. Nice and tall.
I'll get the chair.
All right. And now we're going to turn to your left towards the bed, okay?
Good job, Vanessa. Just turn right around. There you are. Step back to the bed. Nice and easy.
Now that Vanessa is comfortably sitting on the edge of her bed, let's do a quick review. Before providing care, the care provider checked Vanessa's care plan to check her documented mobility status and safe handling and mobility plan. They used PACE to scan the environment for hazards upon entering the room and, after noticing Vanessa had fallen, made sure that Vanessa was alert and responsive, asking questions to determine what happened. Before assisting Vanessa to get up off the floor, the care provider used the call bell to get assistance. While waiting, Vanessa is made more comfortable and told that they will get her up once the nurse arrives to assess her condition. The nurse does an initial assessment of Vanessa's condition, checking for injuries and ensuring that she is able to follow directions, communicate, and isn't agitated. Once the nurse has determined that Vanessa is okay and is able to help herself up, he applies the transfer belt and works with the care providers to safely support and prompt Vanessa as she moves herself up into the chair. Both staff work as a team, assisting Vanessa as she uses her walker to walk to the bed. During this process, a transfer belt is used as both the care provider and nurse stand by in case they need to provide minimal assistance. But what happens if things don't go as expected? Let's rewind and see how the care provider adapts when the nurse indicates that Vanessa isn't able to get herself up from the floor. Remember, when a care provider identifies a need to alter a safe handling and mobility plan, they can and should, making sure that they use a technique that is safer than that outlined in the care plan.
I'm just gonna check your hips and your knees, okay?
Okay.
You have any pain?
I'm a little bit dizzy. I don't think I can get up.
Tara Lynn, can you go get the maxi slide sheets?
Yes, I can.
We're gonna get the slide and we're gonna bring you away from the wall and try to get you up with that, okay?
Okay.
I'll get you to bring your bum out closer to me if you can.
Is there anything else I can help you guys with?
Can you go get the lift and the sling, please?
Yes.
All right, can I get you lay on your back? We're gonna put this under your shoulders.
Okay. I'm gonna take the pillow out, love. I have your head.
Okay.
All right, Jennifer, which side's good for you?
This side's better for me.
All right. Okay, Vanessa, if you could just keep your hands on your belly. Okay, one, two, three. You ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three. Right down under her feet. And we're gonna turn her around with her feet toward the bed.
Okay.
Okay, Vanessa, can you tuck your chin up into your chest?
Put your head up a little bit, sweetheart.
Okay, ready? Bend your knees, honey.
Thump.
Here we go. All right.
You okay?
I'm okay.
Can I have that pillow back, Jennifer? Can you take that bottom sheet out, please?
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Roll the other one into me. Thank you. All right, you can stay right still there, dear.
Okay.
Thanks, Tara.
You're welcome.
Well, Tara, can you get a different one? That one's got a frayed strap on. They all look good. Jennifer, if you want to run the lift, and Tara, you can help me apply the sling. All right, I'm going to get you to roll towards me while she places that sling in behind you. Okay, ready? We're gonna roll on your back again. Little bump there. There we go. All right, through this one. All right, Vanessa, can you lift your legs a little, please? There we go. We'll slide that right up there. And we'll put it on the blue one. And the second we'll put on the gray. And Jennifer, you come around here, please. There we go. All right, you ready? We're going to go for a little ride.
I'm ready.
Okay, we're going to lift you up, Vanessa.
You doing okay?
I'm doing okay.
All right. I'm going to bring your legs out over this way.
Okay.
Okay, Tara Lynn's going to bring up the head of the bed for you.
Thank you.
All right, you ready?
All right, Vanessa, I'm gonna put you down nice and slow.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, Vanessa, we'll take these clips off now here for you.
Okay.
All right. All right, we'll get this out of the way. And now we're gonna do your full assessment, okay?
Okay.
Let's review what you just saw. After assessing Vanessa's condition, the nurse determines that she is unable to help herself get up into a chair and will need more than minimal assistance to do so. The nurse and care providers agree to move Vanessa into an area with more room so that they can safely use a portable floor lift to get Vanessa up. Staff used the maxi slide to move Vanessa away from the wall and toilet and turn her so that she's in the right position for the lift. All three staff worked together, demonstrating excellent communication as they used the portable lift to get Vanessa off the floor. Starting with an inspection of the sling and lift and correctly making the decision to replace the sling with a worn strap, they put the sling under Vanessa, ensured the lift was properly positioned and the wheels weren't locked, and verified what color of loops they should use to put Vanessa into a sitting position when lifted. Vanessa is supported and watched as she is lifted, moved and safely lowered onto her bed so that the nurse can do a more complete assessment. Excellent communication and teamwork to ensure the safety of Vanessa and all the staff. This video has demonstrated some of the most important steps care providers should follow when moving or transferring someone they are caring for. One of the most important steps takes place right before care begins, that being checking the care plan and understanding the safe handling and mobility plan before care begins. Using a pre-care check like PACE is also vital. Care providers know that the capabilities of people they care for can change from day to day, hour to hour, and that new hazards often appear in the care environment. PACE helps care providers recognize when adjustments need to be made to how care is provided so that they can deliver care safely and help protect their own health and well-being and the safety of those they care for.